Morning, my dear students, and once again I welcome you back to the English online classes, and let's continue with this Ranga's marriage. This chapter, as I told you in the very beginning itself, is an interesting one because it is little bit different from the lessons which you people have gone through till the present time. And this chapter, as you people know, we can have a quick recall of what we have done in the previous videos. We have seen that Ranga is the accountant's son of the village, and he comes back home from the city Bangalore, where he had gone to study, and most probably he started working there. And it was a great event for the entire village because no one before that had ever gone out or stepped out of the village, and because of that reason it was really like a festive time for each and every one of the village. Now let's come to the narrator. The narrator, he has titled this chapter to be Ranga's marriage, because he says that for him it was all about Ranga, the boy of the village. So because of that reason, he never wished to give any other title which seems to be fancy or more attractive. He kept the title simple to bring the simplicity of the chapter. And then he speaks about his village Hosahalli, about which he feels very pitiful that nobody knows about it or heard about it. And he never blames anyone because he thinks that when the big people never bothered, how others will come to know about this village. Then he starts talking high about his village, like Hosahalli is which is situated in Mysore, is like the sweet filling in the festive sweet called as Karikadabu. And then he says that he is not the only one, there are many people, like one he mentioned here, a doctor who also speaks high about Hosahalli. And then leaving that, he came to two big specialities of the village which makes the village outstanding according to him. One is the mango tree over there, the raw mango of which is so sour in taste that it can just shake your entire head, giving you a kind of a, you can say that, itchy and very terrible cough, which he came to know only after consuming the chutney made out of that mango. And then he speaks about another thing, that is the creeper which is found in the village pond. He says that the leaves of the creeper seems to be so big, and the flowers of that creeper are very beautiful to watch. And he says that if someone plucks two leaves also, they don't have to bother about it, what the meal has to be served that particular meal time. And then he speaks about English. He speaks about how this rare commodity was really very rare in those times about which he speaks of, though now in the present time it could be everywhere, in every nook and corner, with people talking in English, etc. And then he says that one incident he has narrated over, where he found that he himself felt very ashamed when he was not able to understand that little word given over there, or spoken by one of the son of his friend. And then he asked for the meaning to Ranga. And then comes like, it has been considered a priceless commodity, not available to everyone, not affordable by everyone. And then comes the main part of the story, that is the gathering of the village people around Ranga's house, because they came to see whether this fellow Ranga, who had gone out of the village, is still the same. There he encounters, means our narrator encounters, a boy whom he calls empty-headed, stupid, mannerless, the youth of today, etc., etc., because he gives back a very terrible answer to our narrator's question. And then he said that nice that people didn't go inside Ranga's house, because otherwise it would have turned like the black hole of Calcutta, with all the people suffocating and dying there. And then he speaks about one old lady who was standing near Ranga, how she goes and spreads her palm over the chest of Ranga to have the trace of Janevara over there, Janayu, and means the sacred thread which had been put around him during the time of Janayu. And then when she find it over there, she declares that he had not left his caste and he still belongs. And then everyone disappears like the sugar in the mouth, sugar lump in the mouth of a child. But he stood there, and after everyone has left, he met Ranga, asked him about how he is, and Ranga, he praises Ranga at this particular moment to be a very cultured boy, and that makes him different from everybody else. He bowed down, touched his feet, did a namaskara, took his blessings, not like the young people of today who just halfway through takes the blessing from the knee of the elders. And this is what how he did a comparison, and then he inquired. You can say that he did some queries, some exchange of talk was there between them, and then he left. That very afternoon, Ranga came to his house with some couple of oranges, for which he praises Ranga, that Ranga seems to be a very cultured fellow again. According to him, Ranga was a very, you can say that, generous, considerate, mannered, etc., all kind of good qualities, no, that a noble person is supposed to, a noble person he was. So according to him, this noble person who was the most eligible bachelor of the village must get married, settle down, and be a do a service to the society. And this is what was the thought of our narrator. But all his ideas, all his dreams, castle that did just collapse, because when he, after a little bit of tidbits from here and there, he straight away asked Ranga that what he thinks about marriage, and Ranga, he said that I'm not planning to marry now. And then it was a shock for the narrator, because he started inquiring from him that why he said so. To that, Ranga gave lots of reason, like he would like to marry a mature girl because he had seen one of the officer marrying a maturely girl, and theirs is a very good marriage. Then he speaks about the Dushyanta and Shakuntala story, in which Shakuntala, being a mature girl, was able to handle the situation very beautifully. And then he says that that's why he is not going to marry right now. And then the narrator asked him that whether there is any other reason for not getting married. Then he said that I would like to marry a girl whom I admire. Means he wants a mature girl also, as well as he somewhat want a love marriage. He wants to fall in love with a girl, and he don't want a girl of arranged marriage who will be like not that lovey-dovey type. And because of that reason, he is not wishing to marry right now. Our narrator went into depression, you know, literally he went into depression, because according to him, the most eligible bachelor of the village was saying a big no to the marriage. And then he decided within himself, he made a promise to himself that he is going to get Ranga married. I told you in the very beginning of the video, the first video itself, that outsiders are more interested when a person grows up, whether it's a boy or a girl, to get that person married. So now let's come to our narrator's plot, plans, manipulations, etc. Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11, had come to stay with him. She was from a big town, so she knew how to play the veena and the harmonium. She also had a sweet voice. Both her parents had died, and her uncle had brought her home. Ranga was just the boy for her, and she the most suitable bride for him. Since I was frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, the girl was quite free with me. I completely forgot to mention her name, Ratna. It was the very next morning, I went to the house and told Rama Rao's wife, I will send some buttermilk for you, ask Ratna to fetch it. Okay, so from here onwards, there is a twist in the story, and it's going to make the story a little more interesting and spicy as well. Little manipulations, a cunning mind is going to work hard for bringing this Ranga to marriage. Now the separate story being created by the narrator, or you can say that a movie being directed by the narrator, starts in this manner. He is talking about a girl. This girl, she is the niece, Bhanji. She is the niece of Rama Rao. You remember Rama Rao? The same person whose son purchased the bundle of firewood and said that, I don't have change, come tomorrow. Yeah, the same Rama Rao. That Rama Rao, she's having a niece. Okay. And she's staying with them. And her age is 11. Please mind the age. Okay. Her age is 11. And actually she lived in a town, and because she lived in a town, she knew how to play the veena, the harmonium, and she had a sweet voice, so she can sing very well. The reason was that her both the parents, they passed away, they have died, and because of that reason, Rama Rao, he brought his niece along to stay along with them, and he was looking out for a boy for this girl. And according to our narrator, like how Ranga is the most eligible bachelor, she is the most beautiful bride anybody can look out for. Okay, so now you might be knowing that what is creeping in the mind of our narrator. So he started planning out already. So what he did, he always used to visit Rama Rao's house. So this girl, she was quite free with him, means she easily used to talk and all with him. Oh, forgot to mention her name, and her name is Ratna. Okay, remember the name, Ratna. And the very next morning, our narrator, he reached to Rama Rao's house, and he said to his wife that I have kept some buttermilk for you, you know, and you do one thing, send Ratna to fetch it. Okay, he said this much and he went away. So casual it is, now buttermilk is kept at home. He asked the girl to come and fetch it. Ratna came. It was a Friday, so she was wearing a grand sari. I told her to sit in my room and requested her to sing a song. I sent for Ranga. While she was singing the song, Krishnamurti, in front of my eyes, Ranga reached the door. He stopped at the threshold. He did not want the singing to stop, but was curious to see the singer. Carefully he peeped in. The light coming into the room was blocked. Ratna looked up and, seeing a stranger there, abruptly stopped. Suppose you buy the best quality mango. You eat it slowly, savoring its peel before biting into the juicy flesh. You do not want to waste any part of it. Before you take another bite, the fruit slips out from your hand and falls to the ground. How do you feel? Ranga's face showed the same disappointment when the singing stopped. Okay, a very well planned idea of his, and a very beautiful example. Actually, I really love this example. It's the funniest part, you know. And now this, let me continue the story. So he said that let Ratna come and fetch the buttermilk. Ratna came. It was Friday, so maybe something special, maybe over that side. So she was clad in a very beautiful sari, in a grand sari. It's a very beautiful sari she was. And then he asked her to sit down in his room, and he also requested her to sing a song. She was very familiar with him, so no objection. Okay, that was not the only thing. While he called Ratna over here, he had already sent a message to Ranga also to come and meet him. Okay, so Ratna, on the request of the narrator, she started singing the song. She started singing Krishnamurti in front of my eyes. And meanwhile, Ranga reached there. Okay, she already got a very melodious voice. And as he heard the song, he stopped at the threshold. Threshold means chaukhat pe ruk gaya. And he didn't want the singing to stop, but he was very curious to know who the singer is. So what he did, from the threshold, chaukhat ke paas se, means through the threshold, sunlight was coming inside. So what he did, carefully he peeped inside, means chaukhat ke paas se usne jhuka wo, saamne ki aur. He just bent forward, and then he wanted to have a glimpse, a look of that person who was singing the song. But while he tried to do this, what happened? The sunlight was coming through the threshold, and when Ranga went to bend and went there and bent forward to see who it is singing, he blocked the sunlight. So Ratna, when she saw there was no sunlight, she looked up. And when she looked up, she found a stranger standing there. Seeing the stranger, obviously the shy girl, she stopped suddenly her singing. Now, she had a melodious voice, and a very beautiful song was being sung by her. And when it suddenly stopped, how Ranga might have felt, that is very beautifully explained through an example. I hope maximum of you might love to eat a mango, especially during the summer time. And if the mango is very sweet, nice, pulpy, fleshy, generally how people eat, what they do is that first of all they will take out the skin of the mango, chilka nikalte. I am using a little bit of Hindi over here so that you can actually love the thing which has been explained over here. So first of all they take out the skin, and then from top to end, first they will take out whatever is there in the skin with their teeth. You also might have done. Pura choos ke rakh dete hain us chilke ko, itna sa bhi nahi chhodte. Aapne bhi kiya hoga. You might also have digged into the juicy flesh of mango, but before that you might have taken out every bit of the mango skin. And then after that comes the turn of the juicy fresh pulp in your hand. वो गुटली जिसके आजू बाजू में मीठा, एकदम मीठा फ्लैशी मैंगो पड़ा है, एंड यू आर अबाउट टू टेक इट इनटू योर माउथ, यू आर अबाउट टू डिग इनटू इट, व्हेन सडनली दैट मैंगो सीड स्लिप्स फ्रॉम योर हैंड एंड फॉल्स ऑन टू द ग्राउंड. यू फील लाइक oh, I lost everything in the world. Itna meetha, na majedar, aur wo gutli jab haath se fisal kar niche zameen pe gir jati hai to kitna bura lagta hai. Us samay jo aapko bura lagta hai, right now Ranga was feeling the same thing. He was feeling so, means like as if though he had lost everything when that song stopped. That disappointment could be clearly seen on his face. Wait, this is not the end. More are being given over here. More are there. You sent for me? He asked as he came in and sat on a chair. Ratna stood at a distance, her head lowered. Ranga repeatedly glanced at her. Once our eyes met and he looked very embarrassed. No one spoke for a little long while. It was my coming in that stopped the singing. Let me leave. Words, mere words. The fellow said he would leave but did not make a move. How can one expect words to match actions in these days of Kali Yuga? Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. Okay. After this disappointment, Ranga, he came inside and he sat down on a chair and he asked to our narrator, "You sent for me, means you have called me." And then meanwhile Ratna, little filmy it is, and basically Ratna, like how in the movies and all you might have seen, na, that village girl, people come to see, or otherwise she's in love with a boy, and then she will be standing at by the roadside and she will be looking down shyly with her toe, she will be scratching the ground, etc., etc. So right now Ratna too was standing at a distance and her head was lowered, her means she was not looking at anyone over there. And Ranga, he was again and again glancing at her, you know, chori chupe dekhna, means side glance. And what one particular moment when he was looking at Ratna and then he looked at the narrator, he found narrator was watching him and he was filled with embarrassment. No one said anything. And then Ranga himself said, because I came in such a beautiful song stop, so I must leave. Main jata. Narrator, he said, mere words. Ranga said that, let me go. But he didn't even get up from his chair. He was sitting down there only, sometimes looking at Ratna and sometimes talking to the narrator. And meanwhile, our narrator, he said that in today's day of Kali Yuga, where the action meets the words, our Ranga was going on saying that I'll go, I'll go, I'll go, but he didn't go. He didn't go. He didn't even make a move to move from there. He stayed there only. And instead, Ratna, she was filled with shame or shy. Not that shame, with shyness. And because of that reason, like how I said, in the movies and all, you might have seen the village girl runs inside, a cultured girl, like that only. She also, out of shyness, she ran inside. Okay. Further, after a while, Ranga asked, "Who is that girl, Swami?" Don't get confused. Swami means Ranga calls narrator Swami. So now, inquisitivity, curiosity of Ranga raised up, because he came across a beautiful girl, a girl with a beautiful voice. But please don't forget, she's just 11 years old. And then he asked, "Who's that girl, Swami? Who's that inside?" The lion wanted to know. The he-goat, who had taken shelter in the temple, replied, "Does it matter who I am? I'm a poor animal who has already eaten 9 lions. I have vowed to eat one more. Tell me, are you male or female?" The lion fled the place in fear, it seems. "Like the he-goat," I said, "what does it matter to either of us who she is? I'm already married and you aren't the marrying kind." Okay, you might have to pay a little more extra attention to understand this para which I have read out right now about that lion and the he-goat. It is just the opposite and a vice versa, okay? But fitting into over here. Here, when Ranga asked, "Who's the girl, Swami?" He said one example. Example is something which is really hard to believe, you know. In this, he says that there was a lion, and once that lion reached near a cave or something, and he asked from outside, "Who is there inside?" Actually, inside there was a he-goat, and when he said that, obviously lion can kill the he-goat. And he said that, "Who is there inside?" The he-goat, he said that, "What does it matter who I am? I am a poor animal who had killed already 9 lions, and I want to eat one more. So tell me whether you are a male or a female." And when the lion heard this, he ran away from there. In this story, the he-goat, the cunning one, is our dear narrator, Swami. And the one who is going to be prosecuted or executed or who is going to be sacrificed is Ranga. So he said to Ranga, "What does it matter to you who the girl is? Because I am already married and you are not going to marry." Again, I'm repeating. He said to Ranga, "Tumko kya karna hai? Ki wo kya kaun hai? Because main to already shaadi shuda hoon aur tum to shaadi karne wale nahi ho." Now to this, again further. Very hopefully he asked, "She isn't married then?" His voice did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. "She was married a year ago." His face shriveled like a roasted brinjal. After a while, Ranga left saying, "I must go. I have work at home." When our dear narrator, that our playwright, Swami, he said that, why you are bothered about the girl? I am already married and you are not going to marry me. So with a hope, Ranga asked him, "So that means that the girl isn't married, isn't she?" Then his voice was full of expectation. To that, you know what the narrator did? He said that, "No, she's married a year ago. Oh, just 1 year back she got married." At that time, Ranga's face, it was just like a shriveled brinjal. Your mummy might be making bangan ka bharta. And she, first of all, roast the brinjal, the bangan, on the gas oven to take out the skin. And the skin shrivels, sikur jata hai. Right now, our Ranga's face was all shriveled. Poor fellow. With a high hope, he asked about the girl and he came to know that she's already married. So then he got up and he said to the narrator that, "See, I have got some work at home, so I have got to go." Now, this is just the beginning. Still more is left, and definitely the funnier parts also. So just let's have a pause here, and I will continue with the rest of it in the next class. Till then, goodbye and take care.